Hello, welcome to the Tuesday, December 10th, 2019 edition of the Sands and Storm Sonners Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich, and today I'm recording from Jacksonville, Florida. Well, when I received a suspicious Word document earlier today, I knew OlliDump is the tool I want to use. And lucky for me, we do have a current diary that Didier published yesterday that walks you yet again through a current malicious Word document and shows how to extract and decode some of the malicious code embedded in this document. Given the huge number of malicious documents that we keep seeing, and also the wide range of different sort of obfuscation techniques that the bad guys are using, these diaries are always a great thing because you usually can kind of use whatever is being explained in this diary within a couple days. And talking about new tricks, Sophos has a neat write-up with some details about the Snatch ransomware. This ransomware has been around for a while, but recently apparently added a new trick to its repertoire where it reboots the system into safe mode. So it will first add itself as a service to be started in safe mode, then it reboots the system into safe mode, which will in this process disable mode. Anti-malware products. Malware has always tried to disable anti-malware software and typically just killed these processes. Of course, over the years, anti-malware has become more resistant to these sort of simple shutdown attempts. And I guess the simple thing about safe mode is that it's sort of one size fits all. Pretty much all anti-malware should be shut down in safe mode, so the author doesn't really have to bother with individual software and how to shut it down. Sophos is also going a little bit into sort of the background on this ransomware and, for example, has a couple of job postings that the authors have posted, but they're essentially looking for help to further grow and improve their criminal enterprise. And then, of course, on the other side of the ransomware gangs, we do have security companies and individuals that are trying to come up with ransomware decryptors. And actually, quite often, they are successful in developing software that will help you decrypt your encrypted files without having to pay the ransom. This is, of course, a cat-mouse game, and ransomware is getting better in evading some of the techniques used by these decryptors. But apparently in a recent version of the Ryuk ransomware, things got a little bit bad here in that if your files were encrypted with the latest and greatest version of the Ryuk ransomware, then the older decryptor will not only just not work, but may actually corrupt your files. So they will be lost and you won't be able to decrypt them even if you do purchase the decryption key from the authors of this ransomware. Personally, I of course never recommend to buy a decryption key from ransomware authors. Really just encourages them to write more of it. But sometimes I do understand there are sort of situations where that's your only chance. You should always make a backup of any encrypted files, because even the valid ransomware decryptor that you may purchase from the authors is known to sometimes fail and corrupt files. So yes, you always want to have a second chance to decrypt these files. And also double check to make sure the files are actually encrypted. I've seen lots and lots of cases where the files weren't encrypted, just the extensions changed, but because the victim was quick enough in shutting down the system, or the ransomware just didn't get around to encrypt all the files before noticed otherwise, some of the files may actually still be readable. And I mentioned before that come January, there will be no more updates for Windows 7. So at this point, you're pretty much left with either upgrading to Windows 10 or paying for Microsoft's extended update service. But well, there may be now a third option, and this is a little script that someone came up with that apparently allows you to load and install these extended security updates without paying for them. Probably not legal to run this script. I would be very cautious about doing so. You're downloading essentially some software from a source that you don't necessarily quite know and can identify. There are other options. In some cases, you will get actually at least for 1 year free updates for Windows 7. You can also still update to Windows 10 for free. So that's probably a safer option than applying this script, which appears to do what it's supposed to do, but again, it's not published by Microsoft and it does bypass essentially here Microsoft's controls that make you install these trusted updates from Microsoft. Well, a Twitter user, Swift on Security, is known for a bunch of really valuable content for the security community. And one of these things is a set of Sysmon rules that have been vetted and have been created to identify very specific attack techniques. Now, recently, Sysmon added the ability to also look for DNS requests. Of course, one problem with DNS is you have a lot of requests. A lot of them are benign. So Swift on Security now updated the Sysmon config in order to include DNS requests and also include a fairly extensive and well-researched whitelist of requests that you probably don't want to log, and with that you will minimize your log volume quite a bit. Even if you're using an open source solution like, for example, Elk or so to collect these alerts, where you're not exactly paying sort of per log, but you're still essentially paying for it with additional hardware and such that you need, it's always nice to sort of be able to narrow down what you're logging. Well, and that's it for today. And if you don't have enough of me today, we will have a webcast with RSA at 1 p.m. Eastern. I'll add a link to the show note. This will be at SCOTUS, Heather Mahalik, Alan Poller, and myself. And what we'll do here is sort of update our panel that we always do at the RSA conference. So we'll go over some of the threats that we talked about this spring and sort of show what happened to these threats. So hope to see some of you there, and otherwise talk to you again tomorrow. Bye.